only I had this or that. And life would be so much better if I drove a Cadillac. Well, 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 Elvis Pete had it all. They say he was the king.
We need them. Yes, we do. We need strategies. Strategies for living is what we need.
Yes.
So are you ready? You ready for your daily dose of radio rehab?
I'm not ready. I guess you could say I'm a bit in the dark.
Oh, well, you and a few million other people, huh?
For a couple minutes, anyway.
Yeah, for a couple minutes. Yeah. Hey, folks, welcome. Welcome into 1017 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome into another edition of Strategies for Living. I'm Dr. David McMillan. She is PLPC Lauren Leon McMillan. He is Jimmy Bryant, PhD. That means he produces, he hosts, and he directs. And why am I talking like this?
Because you're in radio.
I'm loving it.
I guess it's my radio voice, isn't it? Yes, Jimmy. When I get into that, you know, you just come in here and kick me. You know, that's what you got to do. Or maybe you tag team Lauren, and she can do that. Yeah. For
you know, I'll confer with her, and then we'll decide.
Y'all come up with a signal.
I do a good head bashing every now and then.
you mentioned the solar eclipse. Why do we get, we have been talking about it. Mm-hmm. We've been talking about it for a good while. I mean, it seems like all of the attention's focused on it. Why are we all so moved? Why are we all so moved by the total solar eclipse and events like this? Well, I think Lauren has some ideas about that.
I have a few. Yeah.
Okay. And, we'll talk about some of those this evening because, I mean, what else is there to talk about except the eclipse?
It's the news of the day for sure.
It definitely is the news of the day. And the good news is that we saw some, you know?
Yeah. I think that the view outside of the path may have been a little underscored this year. I had a blast watching from here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really did.
Yeah. Yeah.
I did too. And I experienced some fun, interesting things too. So.
Well, we will chat about that and more today here on Strategies for Living. Folks, thank you for joining us. And we appreciate our sponsors making it possible. The Robinson Film Center and Azalea Cleaners and Pintail Roofing.
Roof, roof.
And Learning RX and Hempress Cannabis with Love. And the Shreveport Little Theater. Why are we so moved by a total solar eclipse? Well, we'll chat about that when we come back here on Strategies.
Reading begins not in the classroom, but in your child's brain. I'm Donisa Walker with Learning RX Shreveport. If your child struggles to read, maybe he or she has trouble focusing or comprehending, Learning RX Shreveport offers a science solution to reading problems, working one-on-one with your child, targeting his or her reading skills. Today, call Learning RX Shreveport. Make an appointment to have your child assessed. I know you want to help your child. So does Learning RX Shreveport.
Hi, this is Jay Merle for Pintail Roofing. Let's talk about quality. When you hire Pintail to build your roof, here's what you can expect. Quality and quality control are the most important concerns for us at Pintail, and you need to know that Pintail stands tall with swift and professional performance on any warranty call. This is our most important policy. And remember, we're your neighbors. We'll be here for you for the long haul. Our family's lived here for over 100 years, and we aren't going anywhere. On the commercial side of Pintail's business, our fluid-applied roofing solutions can save thousands of dollars over conventional commercial roofing options. Call Pintail at 226-ROOF for a free inspection of your home or commercial building. That's 226-7663. Pintail Roofing. What's the condition of your roof?
And welcome in. Welcome into 1017 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome into the eclipsed version strategies for living.
Yeah. I hope we don't cut out.
I hope not to. No, I don't think we will. I think Jimmy's at the helm.
I got a hold of.
All right.
He's going to keep us out of the. He's flying this thing. He's going to keep us out of the trees. You know.
Get out of the sun.
So what's the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? Right.
Yeah. Well.
Everybody. I mean, you know. I mean, you couldn't. I mean, everybody's been so fired up about this, and rightly so.
Absolutely.
I mean, you know, because it's
an
event.
It won't be for another 20 years.
Yeah,
The one of this size and nature.
One of this, magnitude, right? So what?
2044. August, I think.
Yeah. So obviously, a lot of us here, maybe me included, might not make it to see that one.
I hope you do. I'm counting on you doing it. I hope I do too.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah.
But I mean,
I'm counting on you taking me to the path of totality for that one.
Okay. Well, but I'm just saying that to underscore the rarity of this.
Sure. Yeah,
you know,
right.
And not to be, you know, morbid or anything like that. It's just, it's a human experience. And I mean, one of the things that it does is I think it creates this. Why is there so much talk, including whether we verbalize it or don't verbalize it, thinking about the existential part of this?
Yes.
What's the meaning of this?
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
And I mean, because it does, I think if nothing else, this event has created, as eclipses do, a sense, a collective sense of wonder,
absolutely,
if you will.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's one thing psychologically that I think we can definitely say.
Well, and I might start off with the idea that really none of it has any intrinsic meaning.
Okay.
Okay.
Unpack that, because some people are now saying, what?
Well, you know, that nothing actually has any intrinsic meaning.
Okay.
Okay. It's the meaning that we put on it.
We project meaning.
Yeah.
That's part of existentialism, isn't it?
And I might even argue that this, just like with any and everything and all experiences, is an opportunity to play with lights.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Play with lights.
Yeah. Because it's all energy and it's all lights, including us.
Yeah.
So it's just another opportunity to play.
Whether we perceive it or not, we are light beings.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think you hinted at why it is such a marvel and of magnitude to us is because it's our sun.
Yeah.
And without the sun, we could not exist as we know it or as we experience it.
Whether we think about that consciously or not, we have this inner knowing. We know we can't survive without the sun.
No.
Yeah.
It's literally the center of our universe.
Yeah.
Well, of our solar system. Right?
Yeah. 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 Here comes the sun.
Which was kind of cool. They actually played that in a lot of the areas.
Of course.
Of totality.
Yeah.
When the sun was coming back.
Yeah.
They played the song.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought that was cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. I sat out and watched it today. And it got eerily dark here. I mean, it didn't get as dark as it did, you know, in the path.
Sure.
But it got eerily dark, and I heard crickets.
Yeah.
Yeah. I heard crickets. I thought that was really cool.
Creatures are mixed up.
Yeah. Well, I also heard and experienced a lot of mosquitoes. I will say that, too. There were a bunch of mosquitoes and crickets, and the dog escaped the backyard. So there's that.
Yeah. Well,
they were all
responding to the change in the environment.
Discombobulated.
Yeah. Did you notice when it passed that kind of the what was it like to experience the crickets stopping? Hopefully the mosquitoes.
They lifted.
You know, lifting and, you know.
Yeah. It's almost this transcendence point. It's this really quick way of experiencing light to dark.
Mm.
And that contrast, right?
Yeah.
And kind of a reminder of what we do within ourselves, right? In terms of experiencing both the light and the dark. And we can't exist without one or the other.
Right.
Without either. We right. need them both to experience well, the beauty.
Sure. And in actuality, there is only light and the mm-hmm. absence of light.
Right.
So, I mean, you know, I know that we have created this duality. Mm-hmm. And so we've created light and we call it dark. Yeah. Because we need something to call it, right? Mm-hmm. But when we really get down to it, there is only light.
Right.
And light's right. absence, mm-hmm. which we label dark. Right. Now, I don't mean to, you know, get highfalutin here or anything like that, but it's just, I mean, that's an important thing for us to keep in mind.
No, and it's quote unquote darkness or absence of light based on our physical perception.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
That's not to know that lights are there all the time, all around in varying degrees.
Right.
But our eyes can only see a spectrum, a piece of the spectrum
right.
of light.
Right.
Anyway.
Yeah. And you know, they tell us, and you mentioned dogs a minute ago. Mm-hmm. You know, they tell us that because of the difference in the eyes of a dog mm-hmm. versus the eyes of a human, dogs don't see the same spectrum of color that we do.
Right. They don't have all of the same cones right. that we do.
But we also know that beyond us and what our perceptual ability is, that, you know, and people who have passed over and come back to talk about it, mm-hmm. you know, one of the things that they marvel about, I'm talking about people who have had NDEs, near-death experiences, and they've actually clinically been pronounced dead, mm-hmm. but then they come back, they're revived, or, you know, and then they come back and they talk about the things that they experienced on the other side. And one of the commonalities, there's several, but one of the commonalities in some of the NDE reports, interestingly, is you wouldn't believe the colors.
Right.
Yeah, the colors are so vibrant. They have colors there that are nuances of colors
that we can't even imagine.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
So I mean, which makes sense. You're moving beyond the spectrum of physicality.
Right. And again, that's something for us as humans to, you know, to keep in mind that we are perceptual beings mm-hmm. and everything is going to be within the context of perception. And, you know, hopefully that makes us really contemplate and think about ourselves and our place in the world, both yeah. individually and
as a collective.
Collection,
yeah.
As a collective.
Because what we perceive then is what we're able to collectively create based right. on our perception.
Right. Right. So you started out this morning mm-hmm. and you kind of got some guidance, if you will. Yeah. I don't want to put you on the spot, or what do you feel comfortable about saying? You've shared with us, you know, in past programs that you know you're writing, you know, you're beginning your day. Mm-hmm. Each day, focusing and kind of getting bring-throughs.
whatever you want to call it, information. Yeah. I'm having a conversation with my higher power, myself, my guides, whoever you want to fill in the blank.
Comfortable, whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
What do you think of it as?
What do I think of it as?
Yeah.
Ooh, I think it's kind of, the way I experience it is more of, it's my higher self, but then my higher self, because I can feel as I am writing, the energy will shift, and I can feel a difference in the information that comes through, and so what it feels like to me, and this is the way, you know, I would describe it, is that it's my higher self, but then my higher self connects me with other dimensional beings.
Okay.
Which may or may not be my guides.
Right.
Who help bring through and fill in some information.
Yeah. Okay.
That's the way
I fill in the blanks,
yeah,
if you will.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just to, because I want to get to the, the bring through
the information,
the information, but you know, but not to overbelay that that point. It's like sometimes you will be given information that consciously you don't know, and you'll go back and look it up because you know, again, I've watched her, folks. I mean, you know, it's like she's taking dictation. It's like she's writing down, like taking notes in it, like you would be, like you would see somebody in a lecture class, you know, and you'd walk in class and see people voraciously taking notes. Well, that's what it looks like.
And that's what it feels like. Yeah. It's very fast. And so I'm like just trying to get it down.
Trying to keep up.
And sometimes I don't even write it all down. Sometimes I'll like continue the conversation in my head,
right,
and not get it all down, and I'll try to come back and get it later.
But my point is that when you go back and you read it, or you share it with me, or you go back and reread it and share it, literally share it with your own conscious mind, because you're going so quick that you're not really taking it in consciously the first time. You're just taking it down, but you take it and you look at it, and then some of the stuff you look up, you go, wow.
Yeah. And sometimes it happens in the midst of it. I'll quote unquote argue with it. You know, I'll be that is not what I would consciously think, you know, and they're like, no, you know, just write it. We're going to write it this way. And it happens. It's so funny. You know, like I'll pick a word to write. Even they're very particular about words. I'll pick a word and, you know, they'll come back and they'll say, this word is better. And here's why.
And give you an explanation. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
And some people, and we'll start to share. We got to take a break, but we'll start to share after the break. Some people maybe even say, "Well, I want to do that."
Sure.
Well, here's the bottom line: you can. Everybody can. Mm-hmm. Everybody has Everybody has access and the ability to do, if they take the time and the effort and the want to. At some level, this is available to
absolutely.
You.
Absolutely, it is. Yeah.
And that's, you know, I don't want for people to think
I'm not special.
Yeah, and yet we all are.
Right.
Yeah, you're okay, and I'm glad you said it that way. I'm not special.
I'm not more special than anyone else. Yet we are all special.
Everybody's
and important.
Everybody's special and important. Everybody has something to bring through to the world. And that's the point.
Yep.
That's the message. That's the point that everybody's got to bring through. We're, I don't know. I hope we're not eclipsing the eclipse, but we're talking about the eclipse today here on Strategies for Living. Everybody's talking about it because, man, we've experienced this collective sense of wonder. So we're going to talk more, and we're going to see what came through for Lauren, even before hours before this took place. That's coming back here on Strategies for Living. We'll be right back. You're going to see the difference. When you go to Azalea Cleaners, you'll hear about it too. Azalea Cleaners has been fine dry cleaning since 1958, plus laundry, alterations and repairs, comforters, wedding gown cleaning and restoration. You'll hear about it from your friends because they'll see it too. They'll notice the Azalea difference. Azalea is convenient. 732 Azalea Drive, 9220 Ellerby Road, and 9227 Mansfield Road. Plus, the front door of your home or business with Azalea's delivery on demand. Just text SETUP to 249-8283, and Azalea will pick up your clothes and deliver them back clean and fresh to you. You can't get closer than that. That's the Azalea difference. You'll notice it right away. Others will too. The Azalea difference. Fine dry cleaning since 1958. Text SETUP to 249-8283 and get the Azalea difference. AzaleaCleaners.com. And welcome back. Welcome back into 1017 FM. 710 Kia, welcome back into Strategies for Living. Jimmy Bryant, David McMillan, sitting here at the feet of Lauren Leon McMillan as she is going to share with us. Well, okay, so did you expected to write this morning? You expected to receive some ideas about the eclipse today, the solar eclipse today, right?
So a lot of mornings I just kind of let whatever, you know, I basically ask, okay, what...
What you want to talk about today.
Yeah, what's in my highest good to know for today, okay. Basically.
All right.
But today I did ask. You know, I said, okay, what can you tell me about the eclipse? Like, what is, you know...
Okay, what'd you get?
Okay. So, well, I already kind of shared the first piece that I got, which was, and they wanted to emphasize this, is that, you know, it is, as all things are, multidimensional and devoid of intrinsic meaning, okay. Right?
And so the meaning, again, we all experience it, and we're putting, you know, it is an overwhelming collective moment.
Absolutely. Yeah. And that was mentioned.
It's a moment of awe.
Yeah, that was mentioned later. You know, it came through as it's an opportunity to play with lights, which I mentioned.
Right.
And which, in building up, they, you know, that's a buildup of things they have already explained in terms of what lights are and what that means.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need to go into all of that. But they also suggested that the eclipse could be a reminder for you of the idea that no matter what blocks you put up, you cannot help but shine.
Mm-hmm. So even though the sun is blocked, it's right. Still the sun.
Well, right. And the corona, nonetheless, the corona, the crown, still is visible, mm-hmm. always.
Yeah.
And even though it is such a quote-unquote, you know, perfect coincidence that the moon is 400 times... or the sun, rather, is 400 times the size of the moon.
Right.
And the sun is 400 times the distance from our moon, right? I mean, the perfect, quote-unquote, coincidence in that, right?
Yeah,
right.
How many times do we say we don't believe in coincidence? how many times have I said I've had way too many coincidences to believe in coincidence anymore?
So the perfection of that, allowing for both celestial objects to appear the same size so that they can eclipse in totality. And yet the sun still radiates the corona.
Does that, and I don't mean to get off into this,
right?
But does that not point us
mm-hmm.
into the, I mean, I know we can't prove anything, mm-hmm. but does that not prove as close as we can get to a grand organizing designer.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's G-O-D, isn't it? A grand organizing designer.
Everything, sort of divine intelligence.
Everything in such balance. Everything right. in such order. And that's universally, you know, that's if we look at this in the system that we're a part of, the solar system that we're a part of. We already know there's many more,
mm-hmm.
but we could also come down to bring it down to the system that, yeah, the system of Earth, the gravity and the perfect order. But we could also bring it down to our individual bodies
mm-hmm.
being in such order. And yes, we can get out of balance,
Absolutely.
Out of order. But we're still miracles.
And, right. Not to sound morbid, but it's really easy to die.
Yeah.
It really is.
Yeah,
and
sure.
So the fact that we've made it and we have continued to make it
right.
is a miracle.
It's a miracle. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The fact birth itself, the way, you know, from sperm meeting egg
mm-hmm.
and conception taking place to birth and then the growth, you know, from coming out of the womb, look at, you know, how much we develop mm-hmm. and grow between
and the divine intelligence
and 2 and 3 years old
of the cells that come from pluripotent, which just means that the cells can become anything,
right?
And the intelligence that they know which organs to form and how to form them
right.
in such systemic order.
What do you call those cells?
Pluripotent
cells.
Yeah. Which means they could form many different things.
Yeah, they could end up being a brain cell. They could end up being a part of your skin,
yeah.
or they could end up being in your teeth.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. And it's all about the signaling that happens
right.
within them.
Right.
So anyway, so that was the first thing, you know, that the idea that no matter what blocks you put up, you cannot help but shine.
Okay.
Okay. So the second thing, idea that they proposed was that it could also represent an alignment of three heavenly bodies.
Okay.
Okay, which it is, right?
All right. Yeah, well, you've got the sun, mm-hmm. and you've got this thing called the moon, and then, you've got Earth.
Right.
One, two, three, right?
You brought up a good point there. Yeah. So from your vantage point on Earth, right, it's the alignment of two, but it takes three.
It takes three.
In actuality.
To experience. There's a trinity here.
There you go. Sound familiar? So it's body, soul, and mind.
Yep.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, yes, the sun, which, you know, the prefix for sun is what? Soul. Okay.
Yeah.
So if the sun is representative of the soul. Okay. So this was another point where I argued because little conscious me, if I had to divvy up the Trinity there, body, mind, and soul between the sun, the earth, and the moon.
Yeah.
I would have picked the earth as the body.
Sure.
Yeah.
No. Mm. Okay. And there's an explanation there. But So
you're saying that you got corrected and the earth is the mind.
Right. If it's not the body, it's got to be the mind.
Well, exactly. I think I got that right.
Did you figure that out, 2 + 2?
Yeah, well, I'm trying. I'm trying to keep up here.
I see you over there taking notes.
I'm taking notes, yeah.
Just hang on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we've got that up, but let's talk about real quick. And your sun, your soul. Oh, okay. So this is why they were explaining to me why the moon is the body and the earth is the mind, not vice versa.
Yep.
So let's think about this. Your sun lights the moon.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
The moon is not visibly lit with your eyes.
So that they're saying that that's the same way the soul animates the body.
Mm-hmm.
The body's just a sack of bones.
Right.
The body's just, you are dust and unto dust you shall return. But it's the soul that ignites it, right?
Just like the moon appears bright in your sky due to the reflection of the sun.
Yeah.
Not so unlike your body and soul complex.
Okay. All right.
And the earth is needed as a witness to this divine pairing, much like the mind.
The mind is always witnessing.
That's right. Witnessing the marriage between the body and the soul.
Yeah. That's...
I can dig it.
That is pretty profound, Lauren.
And now let me tell you something else that hit me later in the day. Whatever you call it, God, your higher self, once you connect, you realize that it's always speaking with you.
Yeah.
You know, not necessarily in words.
Yeah. And you may, and again, we've said this a lot here recently. It's not a matter of that your higher self, your higher power, God is not speaking to you. The question is whether you're listening, whether at what point do we tune in? At what point do we listen?
Right. Yeah. Right. And so taking that knowledge that of the mind, the body, and the soul, right? Mm-hmm. And it's about a marriage, a union between the body and the soul being witnessed, just like a minister might witness a marriage. Okay.
Yeah.
The earth is a witness to that. Okay.
Yeah.
So after I watched what we had to offer here of the eclipse, I got this hit. I was like, I'm just going to tune in to, you know, the Weather Channel and check out what the totality is doing.
Okay.
Okay. Which was another experience in and of itself for me.
Yeah.
Because then you get to see and feel that collective, which we can talk about in a minute. But I don't know if you know, but what they call it, right before and right after totality, as the moon is moving in front of the sun, it almost appears like a ring, but there is a little blob, a little like speck of sun still bursting out.
Right.
And they call that moment the diamond ring.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
So as soon as I turned on...
That's what you need in a marriage. You need a diamond, don't you?
Yes. Yeah. As soon as I tuned in to the Path of Totality watching this, what first appeared was they said, it's the diamond ring. And they just all started screaming, right? Because it's entering into totality.
Yeah.
And it just washed over me. Like
because of what you had gotten earlier with the marriage, the marriage thing.
Right.
The sun and the moon, the earth is the witness to
the
sun.
Yeah, because in that moment, I got a tap from them like, see, that's it.
Yeah.
It's a marriage. It is a complete and total marriage.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And we, you know, we collectively co-create that and witness that.
Yeah.
From earth.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just like any good Holy Trinity, right? We have here, there, and in between. And we couldn't have here or there without the in between.
Without the, yeah. Without the space. Yeah.
Right. Without the space.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm. Wow.
So that was a cool moment.
You know, and I can't help but go back, and I don't want to get on a soapbox here or anything like that, but we did spend a little bit of time last week looking at, you know, how we collectively have cared for our planet, our Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Again, maybe no coincidence there that we talked about that last week. We didn't consciously do that, but that's what happened.
No coincidences.
And so, I mean, again, this may underscore for us the importance of, you know, this experience of witnessing and being part of something
bigger
that is bigger than ourselves. This feeling of awe that arises.
Which they mentioned this morning as well.
Hopefully gives us pause. Hopefully helps us to tune in. And I know we've got to get to break, but let's on the other side of break talk about.
Okay.
What, as we tune in, you know, because we're talking about diverse cultures, even in this country, different cultures experienced, you know,
and yet we're all one.
And yet we're all one. Yeah. So we'll chat about that when we come back as we kind of unpack the day's happenings and the eclipse here on Strategies. We'll be right back. You know, it's been going on for 101 plus years. I'm talking about the Shreveport Little Theater, enriching our lives through the performing arts, through educational programming and opportunities to volunteer service, all the while guided by professional artists. You know, SLT, of course, it's a charming and intimate theater. It has earned the national recognition, though, of none other than Life Magazine. Life Magazine named SLT as one of the nation's top three community playhouses. Now, on stage next, starting April the 19th, Jimmy Buffett's Escape to Margaritaville. So you want to get your tickets right now. ShreveportLittleTheater.com is the way to do it. You know, we say it a lot. Shreveport Little Theater is American theater at its best at 812 Margaret Place in Shreveport. ShreveportLittleTheater.com. And welcome back. Welcome back into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome back into Strategies for Living as we unpack the day's events. Man. man. Of
Quite
course,
the experience.
Yeah. We were all moved by this event today, the total solar eclipse and, you know, the unique darkness. That, you know, it's not the same as the pitch blackness of the night sky, but a surreal twilight that changes our daylight world into something extraordinary for just moments, just minutes.
And you know, it was also cool. I didn't realize until I tuned into the Path of Totality. Is that they also experience a 360-degree sunset-like experience on the horizon.
Mm.
because, you know, all of the sun's rays are scattered, just right. like it, just like what happens during the sunset.
Right.
But it's all around because the sun's, you know, up in the sky.
Right.
Not usually at the sunset, it's at the horizon, so we only get a piece of it.
Right.
Which kind of reminded me of the idea of a prism, right?
Okay.
Because the sun's light is white. It's pure white light.
Right.
And we know that that refracts and reflects into the spectrum of light
right.
that
right.
we know, right?
Right.
Much in the same way that love is that white light.
Hmm.
Love is the totality.
Right.
Okay.
And we can see it in all forms, whether yeah. that's any of the emotions.
Right.
Sadness, fear, disgust, greed, hunger. All of those things are love reflected and refracted.
And Lauren and Jimmy, that makes me think back to something we were talking about earlier in terms of, okay, there is, you know, we call it light and dark.
Mm-hmm.
In truth, there's no dark, but there's really what we're experiencing is light and the absence of light. And so to, you know, to kind of jump on that same idea with love,
mm-hmm.
there is love and the absence of love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
On a spectrum.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's, you know, like we experience today, right, with the, especially those in the path of totality, you couldn't have one without the other.
Right.
It's in totality.
Right.
Truly.
Right. And so, you know, that's why I think events like this help to underscore and remind us of, you know, okay, well, just there is only love, but we certainly have all experienced the absence of love
right.
in our lives.
Well, yeah, because if we hadn't experienced the absence, how could we appreciate and know
the love itself?
Right, yeah. What it is.
So we've all experienced this sense of collective wonder
today.
Yeah,
which I got a preview of as well. Let me read you that little snippet from this morning of the idea of the eclipse being, they said, it's also an opportunity for many to co-create as you all engage in the present moment together.
There you go. It brings it, you know, events like today bring us
into the present.
Totally.
Totally.
Yeah.
And that's where we have our ability to create.
Yeah. And everybody that got involved in it today
mm-hmm.
was able to experience the present moment, telling us, mm-hmm. right, that we can experience the present moment anytime that we really want and need to, but we've got to tune in, just like so many people tuned in today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's a reminder of the wonder that awaits us in the present.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't have to be a total eclipse of the sun.
Right.
To have wonder. If
that's an event that can remind us.
Right.
Right? That can remind us of what at some point we all know. Mm-hmm. It's factory installed, if you will, in us.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so it goes on to say, it can be a reminder of your journey to remember your lights and each other as the lights along the way.
Hmm.
Yeah. A reminder of the wonder, beauty, intention you all invested in co-creating the celestial bodies to remind you of your own celestial nature.
Hmm.
The wonder, beauty, and intention that exists within you as lights of the universe, co-creating the internal made external together.
Mm. So the universality of human experience, you know, experiencing a total eclipse, it does and can, we talked about perspective. This can, if we allow it to, it can affect our perspective. Maybe, you know, leading us,
mm-hmm.
if we so choose, on a heightened sense of humility, you know, a heightened sense, you know, of, and when I when I say the word humility, keep in mind that, you know, humility, human.
Which,
do you see the connection?
Yeah, you're stealing that from my bring through the other day.
Yeah.
But
yeah. But I figure that bring through was for a purpose.
Absolutely.
Leading up to this. Yeah.
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 Yeah, because Hume, by the way, the etymology of humble and humility comes from H-U-M, right? And it's Latin humus, which means ground, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then it translated to humulus, which means low or lowly.
Yeah.
Okay? But that doesn't necessarily have to have a negative connotation.
Yeah.
It's important that we ground our light.
Just think about it. The awe that was sparked by the majesty of this eclipse today, if we allow it, mm-hmm. it could encourage us, if we allow it, to extend our awareness beyond the mundane, mm-hmm. beyond the everyday personal concerns that we get so eclipsed with. Yeah, because researchers have found that individuals caught in the moment mm-hmm. tend to use language that reflects a greater acknowledgement of their own limitations and a broader appreciation for, you know, somewhat paradoxical universality of human experience.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, you know, that we all were in different places today, yet we all had a similar opportunity for the same experience. And yet, because we all come from different places, backgrounds, ideologies, we all truly had a very different experience of it.
And yet you had a moving experience. I mean, a piece of music, a piece of art can do that.
Sure.
We might have very different, each person might interpret, let's say, a song different.
Oh, yeah, right.
And yet.
And it means something different to everyone.
And yet, but it moves, you know, mm-hmm. it moves us. And so.
It reminds me of like a concert, right? You all go to your favorite band or whatever, and you come to like the band for varying different reasons. Like perhaps the songs got you through a particular point in your life.
Yep.
Perhaps some people just liked the beat.
Yep.
Whatever it is, you were moved. And if you all get together there in the concert, you can feel that universal sense of unity through your own individual perception.
There you go. I think to quote Carol King earlier today, we all felt the earth move under our feet. We are we're talking about the eclipse. We all experienced it today, or at least a lot of folks did. And we're talking about it today here on Strategies. We'll be back. Just how many times do I have to say it? How many times do I have to say there's no place like the Robinson Film Center? How many times?
You can't say it enough.
This place is
absolutely amazing.
I can't. 617 Texas Street. Downtown Shreveport. Yeah, there is no place like the Robinson. And, of course, right now, if you have not been back to Abby Singer's Bistro to see the newly renovated dining room, you got to go. You got to go. And, of course, you know, everybody's excited about the movies right now. We watched the Oscars.
That's right.
And we were on the edge of our seats. You know, there's always something great going on at the Robinson. RobinsonFilmCenter.org is the way you find out. Look, I got a great idea. Join the crowd. Join the fun. You want to become a member. Get discounts on movies. Get concession upgrades. Get bistro deals. RFC, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport, RobinsonFilmCenter.org. And welcome back to Strategies for Living. Lauren Leon McMillan, Jimmy Bryant, David McMillan. You know, there was a study that was published in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology, and it suggested that just experiencing awe, mm-hmm. the feeling of wonder in response to something vast beyond our usual understanding, can lead to a more selfless and caring behavior. The study found that people who are naturally more prone to feeling awe tend to be more generous, more likely to make ethical decisions, and value helping each other, helping one another, mm-hmm. even being surrounded by tall trees.
Oh, yeah.
Can induce a sense of awe, making people more willing to help others. And, you know, we can't have an eclipse every day, but we can.
We can experience awe every day.
And I think that's maybe one of the takeaways of today, because it's vital to remember that awe-inspiring moments can be found not only in the grand celestial events like a solar eclipse or meteor showers, but also in the little wonders of daily life.
Absolutely.
You know, the miracle of birth, the miracle of a baby, the miracle of a 2-year-old, or the miracle of a 90-year-old.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Observing nature's marvels. It seemed like everybody was confused this morning on our way to work. On the way to the office, there was a possum out.
Yeah, there was.
You don't usually see a possum during the day.
It was a pretty big guy.
Pretty big guy out in somebody's front yard.
Yeah.
But we saw it. So, I mean, again, you know, there you go. The sense of wonder can lead to a better world. And that's what I hope we can remind ourselves of.
I like the word wonder.
Yeah.
One wonder.
Yeah. Folks, thank you for tuning in to Strategies for Living. Thanks for wondering with us today. And we appreciate our sponsors making it possible. The Robinson Film Center, Azalea Cleaners, Pintail Roofing,
Roof.
Learning RX, and Empress Cannabis with Love, the Shreveport Little Theater. If today were the last day of your life, you only had one more phone call that you could make, who is it that you'd call? And what is it that you'd say? And why are you waiting? Make the call. For Jimmy Bryant, for Lauren Leon McMillan, I'm David McMillan. See you next time right here on Strategies for Living.